بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أبنائي الأعزاء، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. من منصة شركة الجامعة للتعليم والتدريب متوسطة الجامعة، معكم معلم اللغة الإنجليزية الصف الثالث متوسط، المعلم عماد الدين السيد. Dear students, peace and the blessings of Allah be upon you all. Today we are going to discuss together Module 4, Round Up 4, Part 2. And now we are going to start together with this question, question D. Read the direct questions and form indirect questions. This is the question. But before we go on doing this or answer the question, we need to revise some grammar points together, which are about how to change the question from direct into indirect. First of all, I have to use one of these four phrases. Would you tell me? Could you tell me? Can you tell me? Could you inform me? Can you inform me? Could you inform me? Can, could, would you let me know? Or the last one, do you know? One of these four phrases or questions, we will start the indirect question with. For example, if I have a question like that, where is the hotel? So I have to use one of these questions. Can you tell me? Could you tell me? Can you inform me? Would you inform me? Can or could you let me know? Do you know? And then I will change the question into a statement, you know. Do you know where the hotel is? I will change the order of the question. I will start with the question word. Then I will order the question like the statement or the sentence. Subject, then helping verb and the verb and so on. Okay, that's it. Let's do the first question. How dangerous is that slope? This is question number one. We need to form indirect question. So he gave us part of the answer. Do you know? Do you know? Then I will use how at the question word. How that slope is dangerous, or how dangerous that slope is. One of these two sentences. So it's going to be how dangerous that slope is. Number two, what time does the travel agency close? Here we want or we need to change it into a statement or into indirect. Could you tell me what time? So I will use is in the verb instead of does. So it is going to be what time the travel agency closes. So because it is in the present simple, so it is going to be like that. What time the travel agency closes? This is number two. Number three, which bus goes to Banbury? Let's use one of our questions. Can you tell me? Can you inform me, please? Can you please inform me? Can you please tell me? Because this is which about this is a request. You want to ask someone politely about the bus which goes to Banbury. So it's going to be like that. Can you please tell me which bus goes to Banbury? So this is the question. We will not change it anymore. Can you tell me which bus goes to Banbury? Because it is in the correct order in the question. Number four, where will I find souvenirs? This is the first part of our answer. So do you know where, yeah, will replace I and will. I will change the order of this question. So it is going to be where I will find souvenirs. So it is going to be, do you know where I will find souvenirs? This is number four. Number five with us today. Who is that young man? Could. Here we need to change this question into indirect. So it's going to be, could you tell me? Could you please tell me who that young man is? So I changed the order of the statement. So it's going to be who that young man is. That's it. Number six. Where is the library? The library, he asked about library. And this is a polite request as well. We can say, can you tell me, or can you please tell me where the library is? So it's going to be like that. Can you please tell me where the library is? This is an indirect question. Number seven. What time does the train leave? He gave us could as a key to the quest, to the answer or a clue. So let's make it. Could you tell me? Could you please tell me? Could you let me know what time the train leaves? So this is the question. Could you please tell me what time the train leaves? This is number seven. Eight. Who wrote that poem? Do you? Here he gives us the answer to be do you. Do you know? Do you know? Do you know who wrote that poem? Or who was that poem written by? So both of these answers are correct, but let's take the easier one, which is, do you know who wrote the poem? Nine. Why are you late again? This is a question direct. I'd like to change it into indirect. So it's going to be, can you please tell me why? Are you is going to be you or late again? Why? You, can you tell me why you are late again? That's it. Number 10. How often does Carlos have an English lesson? Yes, excellent. How often? This is the question word. Do you know how often? I'll delete does and write has instead. So it is going to be like that. How often Carlos has an English lesson? Okay, that's it. Now let's go to the second question with us today, which is about communication. This question is communication and listening one. Question E is about listening. So let's listen first to the text, then we are going to do the exercise together.
Four, round up. Communication. E. Complete the dialogue with the phrases A to G. There are three extra phrases which you do not need to use.
Are you painting a picture, Todd?
Yes, but it's not very good.
Don't talk nonsense.
It's great.
Do you think so?
Yes. I didn't know you were an artist.
Well, I like to paint from time to time.
You should have your own exhibition.
No, I'd make a fool of myself.
Don't be silly. Actually, there's a competition at the town hall every year. You should enter.
But I haven't finished this painting yet.
The competition isn't until the summer, so take your time.
Okay. First of all, let's take it step by step. It's a good laugh. Well, I like to paint from time to time. That's disgusting. So, take your time. E. Don't talk nonsense. F. No, I'd make a fool of myself. G. Take a break. So these are from A to G, which we are going to choose and finish the dialogue together. Here, we have Steve and Todd talking about painting pictures and so on. Let's start reading this dialogue. Steve, are you painting a picture, Todd?
Yes, but it's not very good.
Space, it's great. What do you think? Is it A, B, C, D, E, F, or G? I think it is going to be E. So it's going to be like that. Don't talk nonsense. It's great. Do you think so? Here Todd want to make sure of his friend's opinion about his painting.
Yes, I did. I didn't know you were an artist.
Todd gave him a sentence here. It's going to be B, yes. Well, I like to paint from time to time. This is his opinion about painting. Steve, you should have your own exhibition. So, number three, I think it is going to be no, I'd make a fool of myself. He wants him to join the competition or something like that, but he is not sure about himself. Don't be silly, actually. There is a competition at the town hall every year. You should enter. Todd says, but I haven't finished this painting yet. The competition isn't until the summer. Okay, here is going to be yes. Take a break. Is it good? No, I don't think so. So it's going to be so. Take your time. Yeah, definitely right. This is the correct one. So now we finished it. Anyway, I'd like to listen to it again.
4. Roundup. Communication. E. Complete the dialogue with the phrases A to G. There are 3 extra phrases which you do not need to use.
Are you painting a picture, Todd?
Yes, but it's not very good. Don't talk nonsense. It's great.
Do you think so?
Yes. I didn't know you were an artist.
Well, I like to paint from time to time. You should have your own exhibition.
No, I'd make a fool of myself. Don't be silly. Actually, there's a competition at the town hall every year. You should enter.
But I haven't finished this painting yet. The competition isn't until the summer. So take your time.
Okay, so we did well. Anyway, my dear students, thank you so much. And enjoy your time. Thank you, and hope you get the best benefit of your time. Thank you and goodbye.